Yodeling is a dying art. And people, it is dying for a reason. And it has a DNR. Today, we're gonna talk about the Walmart Kid. Yes, the yodeling Walmart Kid and the state of the industry. We'll do it all on the other side of the intro. Roll it. Gather up you weary souls, show them you ain't dead. Tell them all you ain't coming home. Hey guys, and welcome back to the first vlog this week. That's right, I said the first vlog this week. Sorry for not uploading last week, but I had to go to the dentist and it ended up being a 2-day thing, and like one day the left side of my face was numb and then the next day the other side of my face was numb. So I just couldn't get with the program last week. But it enabled me to have some time kind of sit down and think about what I'm going to be doing over the weeks and months to come with the channel. That being said, I'm going to start uploading 2 videos a week on Tuesday and again on Thursday. And then I'm also thinking about doing a live stream on Wednesday nights that will live stream from YouTube to Twitch to Facebook Live to Instagram. Basically anywhere you can watch live content, it will simulcast at the same time all those different platforms. And that'll give us a chance to hang out live. You can ask questions about the music business, songwriting, producing records. We can talk about tech. We can talk about cameras and monitors and lights. We can even talk about Fortnite, because I got to be honest, I've been kind of a Fortnite freak lately. But I'm thinking about doing that and starting a live stream on Wednesday nights. If you would love to take part in that and you think it's a good idea and you'd love to do it, just mention something in the comments below. Always love to hear you guys, from you guys, and I love answering your questions, and I just thought that would be a good way for us to kind of be able to all get together and have a little bit of sense of community. And it'd be live. If you want to ask questions, you can tweet them, post them on Instagram. You can watch on YouTube and do instant chat right there. And I can answer them live. We can talk about all kinds of stuff. But that's all coming, and it's all planned out for the kind of rolling out over the next couple of weeks. But I'll let you know more as we go along. As always, guys, if you haven't already, please subscribe to the channel. Love it when you do that. Click the subscribe button and click the little bell next to it, so that you're notified every time I upload new content. All right, let's jump in. I'm sorry. That's all I can say is I'm sorry. I sit here and I'm frustrated, a little bit angry, to be quite honest with you. I wish that I could say shocked or surprised, but I'm not. I've been in the music business for over 20 years. I have been fortunate enough to have written number one songs for several artists. I've produced number one songs for several artists, and as well as multi-platinum selling albums, and written and produced music for television shows like Nashville, The Vampire Diaries, and feature films, and even a presidential campaign. But I'm sitting here and I'm apologizing to you. Let me preface what I'm getting ready to talk about by first saying that I'm not in any way condemning or coming down on or ridiculing or criticizing Mason Ramsey, aka the Walmart Yodeling Kid. Now, if you've lived under a rock for the last month and you haven't seen it, you might want to check it out. I'm going to have a little bit of it. Let's roll that clip. This was a viral video. They uploaded this video. This kid is yodeling in Walmart. And basically he's singing and yodeling a classic Hank Williams Sr. song. And this thing went mega viral. Like, I think the original video has over 34 million views on it. And in the last 4 weeks, people have done trap remixes and people have reposted the video. Overall, the thing's got well over 100 million, 200 million views as far as impressions overall, which of course landed him on Ellen. And anything, it's almost like Oprah and her book club. Ellen is to independent artists what Oprah is to authors. Anytime Ellen gets behind anything music, it just explodes. And so that's exactly what it did. So I want to say that I'm not criticizing young Mason or his talent level, but I want to talk about what this says about our industry, because I woke up the other morning and I was reading industry news from an industry source, and I saw that the headline read, Walmart Yodeling Kid signs with Atlantic Records. And it just kind of blew me away. Like I said before, I can't say that I'm surprised, because that's where our business has gone. The major labels, even independent labels, would rather sign a viral video than go sign a talented, hardworking, unsigned artist and then put the time and money and passion into developing that artist, into launching them into the mainstream. It's just so much easier to go pluck somebody that's had a viral video and cash in quick. Speaking of cashing in, this isn't the first time we've seen this. Let's go back a couple of years to the Cash Me Outside girl. I don't even know her name. I just know she was on Dr. Phil, and that, of course, went viral. She as well signed a record deal. Now, back to Mason Ramsey. So his video goes viral. It's a cute video. He's a cute kid. I think he's like 11 years old. So I'm not trying to be negative on him at all. More power to him. I love to see anybody succeed at what they're passionate about. What I'm focusing on in this video, though, is more from the industry perspective. So when I say some of the negative things that I'm going to say, please know and understand that I'm not criticizing Mason. And I'm not critiquing him in any way. God bless him. More power to him. I'm concerned, though, at what it does for our industry. Those of you that follow this channel and you've followed my career, you know that over the last 10 years, I have developed a real heart for independent artists, for those artists that are struggling, that are trying everything they know to do to get to the next step, to get to the next level, to get noticed, to get out on the road, to actually get paid to play their music or get paid when they sell it. So when I see something that just is a fly-by-night, happens literally overnight for something that is, for lack of better terms, kind of a gimmick, you know? I mean, nobody is begging for classic country music to be played on the radio anymore, or stream, or videos, or anything. There's not a huge mainstream call out for classic country music. But yet, here's an 11-year-old kid in Walmart yodeling a Hank Williams Sr. song, and the world goes nuts, and it goes viral. And all these things start to trickle. He goes on Ellen. He does that. He goes and performs at the Grand Ole Opry. It's just one thing after the other. Then you hear he's signing with a major record label, Atlantic Records. It's in partnership with Big Loud here in Nashville. That's what frustrates me, because I work with so many of you and I hear from so many of you. I get emails from so many independent artists. Please help me. What can I do? And a lot of times I listen to their music, I look at what they're doing, and they're extremely talented. And they're right in the center of the road. They're right where the business is right now. Their music is modern. It sounds great. The production is sounding great, especially the artists that I produce and work with. No, that's another video. But it's hard for me to watch you guys struggle and then watch something like this overnight be so successful for something that our industry, and especially the country music industry, doesn't even embrace, which is classic country music and yodeling. Let's face it, if I'm going to say anything critical about Mason, it's going to be this, and it's not even about Mason, really. It's about yodeling. Look, yodeling is a dying art. And people, it is dying for a reason. And it has a DNR. So can we please respect its wishes? I don't get it. I really don't get it. I get why the video went viral, because he's a cute kid. And he's standing there and he looks like Howdy Doody. And he's yodeling, which you don't ever hear. And he's singing a classic Hank Williams Sr. song. You just add 11-year-old kid yodeling in Walmart, and you add all that together, it's bound to go viral. So where are we today? This kid has come to Nashville, has performed at the Grand Ole Opry. He's got now a viral video, and he signed a major label recording contract that most of you guys would give your left arm for. Now, what did they do? You want to know why our business is in the shape that it's in? There's two reasons, and I'm going to talk about both of them with you. First of all, they sign an 11-year-old kid that was made famous by a viral video of him standing in Walmart yodeling. So what do? The major label brings him to Nashville, signs him, takes him into the recording studio, and records a song that is neither classic country, nor does he yodel anywhere in the song. The song is called Famous for Loving You. It was written by one of the guys in Florida Georgia Line, Sarah Buxton. I think Corey Crowder was a writer on it, and there may have been one other person. Yeah, it took four or five people to write this gem. And I'm not there again. I could be negative about that, and I'm not. What I'm saying is people scratch their head and they wonder why the music business has gone down the tubes. This is it. You sign a kid because he has a viral video of himself yodeling in Walmart. So you bring him to Nashville, you record a song that is the most modern country sounding song, bro country, if you will. He's not yodeling anywhere in it. And the song's called Famous for Loving You, where he talks about all these different things and his newfound fame. But the premise of the song is that if I'm going to be famous, I want to be famous for loving you. He's 11 years old. Outside of his mom and dad and family members, who's he had a chance to love? Nobody. That's what I'm talking about, guys. It's the fake and the phony. Why not bring the kid to Nashville and do what it was that made him successful? Cut an album of classic country songs on him. Let him do the yodeling. If you want to cash in quick, then be smart enough to reproduce the product that people made him famous for. But that's our business. They find something they like, and they find something that managed somehow to bypass their system. So the only thing they know how to do is swoop in, grab up that product, and force it through their model. I started out by apologizing and telling you that I'm sorry. And the reason I'm doing that is I sat here today as a professional in this business. I believe I'm a representative of this business. Having had tremendous amount of success in this business. I'm sorry because I want each one of you guys to know that it shouldn't be this way. For every one of you guys, girls, bands, you're out there and you're struggling and you're driving around in that beat up, broke down vehicle that barely gets you from A to B. And you're going and you're playing someplace that it takes you $600 to get there and you're only making $500 when you get there. I'm sorry for situations like this. For all of you that are out there that are super talented, that I hear from on a regular basis, that you have a great voice, you have the passion, you have the work ethic, you have the plan, you know your path to success, and you get up and you go stand in the middle of those tracks every day. I'm sorry. There's nothing you can do to plan a viral video. Trust me, if there was, we would have all done it. And I know you would have done it too. But what I want to, the message I want to try to get across to you today is that when you see things like this, and you see things like the Cash Me Outside girl, and you see the things like the American Idol winners and the people that have been on The Voice, think about this. Again, I'm not saying anything negative about Mason Ramsey. God bless him, and I wish him all the luck in the world. But my experience in this business tells me that flashes in the pan die pretty quickly, and their flame doesn't last. Think about The Voice and American Idol and America's Got Talent. Sure, they have a fuse, and they get that fuse lit. But the flame doesn't generally last very long. So when you guys see these things and you're like me and you get frustrated and you get angry and it bothers you because you think about all the hard work that you've put in, don't give up. Don't let this be a discouragement to you. Use this as fuel to change our industry because you're the only one that can do it. Talent, great songs, hard work, it will always overcome these flash in the pans. So don't let it get to you so much. I'm kind of preaching to myself at the moment because I really let it get to me the other day. I was throwing things, screaming, because it just really frustrates me. I know 10 people that I've worked with in the last year that are some of the most talented people that I've ever seen in 20 years in this business, and they're having a hard time. And then you see the Walmart Yodeling Kid have a viral video, and now it would seem that his life is laid out for him and the red carpet's been rolled out. And you know, you sit and you think, man, if I knew that's all it would have taken, I would have been down there yodeling in Walmart for the last 20 years. We can't control these things. My message is to you is to keep pushing forward. Keep showing the world your talent. I promise you that the ground that you're making up and the steps that you're taking are building a far more solid foundation underneath you than the Walmart Yodeling Kid. Guys, I hope you got something out of the vlog today. It's just something that was really impressed upon my heart. I know that a lot of people were frustrated about seeing this, and there's a lot of artists, a lot of you guys out there working very hard for every little inch of success that you get. And I just want you to know that I'm with you, and I see you, and I hear you, and I want you to keep going. I want you to keep being successful and building that path to success for yourself. That's what I'm here for too. Thank you so much for hanging out on the channel. Thanks for watching the video today. There's gonna be another one on Thursday. That's right, we're going to 2 videos a week, and I hope you're gonna enjoy them. As always, don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. Hit the subscribe button. Hit the bell next to it so that you're notified every time I upload new content. And if you want to follow me on social media, it's at TheSteveFreeman on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter. And now Twitch. Yes, I now have a Twitch channel, and we'll be live streaming. Who knows? I've been playing a lot of Fortnite. We might get on there and do some live streaming with Fortnite as well. Guys, until next time, keep being creative, keep pushing the boundaries, and there's nothing wrong with being independent. See you next time.